So, what is this? It's a measurement gauge, just like this. I'll show you how to use it. Coming up. Hey, Chanel here, bringing you weekly videos to help you get better and better with your fashion sewing and be more creative too. So be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you never miss out on a new video. So measurement gauges. We use these a lot at my sewing school. They're probably one of our most frequent tools that we use. And I had a student the other day who didn't know how to use it. So she skipped my beginner class, which is we always just show what the tools are and the ones we use the most frequently. And she jumped right into my intermediate class because she took sewing somewhere else. Anyway, just thought about that. So basically, it's a ruler, and the whole reason for this ruler, or the whole reason to buy this ruler, is for this little tab right here. And it just marks your space. So you put it like you want to do something 1 inch right there. You'd actually put it on the raw edge of fabric, and then you make a mark right on the top. And it just marks, keeps track of your measurement. There's a little downside. I have a lot of kid students in my school, and they, as soon as they get this in their hand, they go like this, and then this starts to slip. And a lot of times you'll just put it down on it, and it moves. It starts to move like this as you're pressing. I'll show you at the table how to use this, but they're like pressing it here and it starts to move, and then they don't have their accurate measurement. The other thing too, then they'll kind of press it down like this, and then this is like stretched right here, which is not a big deal. You can snap it back there, but they'll get weak. But I change these out a lot, like at least twice a year, and just get fresh ones. They're not really expensive. And I'll buy them by the bulk a lot of times in downtown Los Angeles for like $1 a piece. And they'll either come with the blue tab or the red tab. And they're just a great tool. I also want to show you what that little hole in here is for. There's actually a reason. And just give you quick tips on how to use this. Also, there's this new one on the market. Actually, I don't know how new it is. I think this was by Clover. And I thought, I gotta try this because right here, you just mark it, you just have little marks. And this one right here, you can put a large, a longer line on it, longer mark. But so I bought one to try it at my studio, and I thought, okay, I kind of have a little bit of hard time figuring out the measurements on here. So this actually says right here, push right there. And I was using it and like keeping it out of the general sewing tray till I got to use it, but then I left it in there, and then I went back to use it, and all of a sudden it's broken. So I think somebody just doesn't know how to use it. They push too hard and they cracked it right here. It doesn't look broken, but it doesn't lock in place right there. So you're supposed to push it and it would lock in place. It was really great. So I won't be buying these for my school because then these were a little more expensive. I can't even remember. Maybe, I don't even know, $5 to $10 somewhere. But if I had to buy, I like to have six of them because I have a maximum of six students in here so that everybody has one. And these are just a little more efficient, but I do for myself would have liked to have used this, but I still can. I just have to know that this slips pretty easy like that. So I'm going to show you how to use these on fabric and what the reason for them is. I use them a lot. I used to call it a hem gauge because I used them for hemming. Also great for spacing out buttonholes, and just we use them generally for marking seam allowance on there. So let me show you on some fabric. All right, so to do a seam allowance, most seam allowances in patterns are 5/8 of an inch. So the first eighth on this hem gauge here, measurement gauge, is covered up by the hole right there. So there's a 1/8, then you got 2/8, 3/8, 4/8, which is a half, and then 5/8. So you just put the tab on the 5/8 right there, and then you can mark your fabric. So you're going to mark a seam allowance here, and then we just put a mark right there, and that's how we kind of mark the seam. This is great for my beginner students until they learn how to use the seam guides, and so they have the marks right there. Then they just pin it, and then they go and sew right there. So you have the marks. It just keeps it right there. If you want to hem something, like let's say this skirt right here, take all this off. You just got this little skirt. This is why I call it a hem gauge. You just find the, you know, your layers there. And then let's say we're going to hem this 2 inches. I just put that on the bottom of the two. And then I put it on, I always call it on the raw edge. Obviously this isn't raw, but sometimes it might be. That's where just it's cut. This is actually folded up. But let's say this was a hem and you were altering it. So you wanted to hem it up 2 inches. You just put it right there on the two, make a mark. This is with the wax chalk. Make a mark right there. And then just go all the way around it. And then this is your pressing mark right there. So again, 1 inch would be, if you wanted to hem it 1 inch, you put it on the one, and then you make your mark. So that's how those work. Now, if you want to do, use this one here, this one is, it took me a while to get used to this, but like the 1 inch is right there, right here. So if you put the green tab on the one right there, and you go, you put the whole base of that green part right, let's make sure you can see this, you put the green part right on that raw edge there, or the edge, and then you make a mark. So it's a little bit wider, it's just kind of easier, but this is supposed to, like, you just push it and then it locks it in place, which is actually also really great. Hard to do this with, try not to get shadows here. We go like that. So if I wanted to do two, I'd put that green part right there on the two. You can see I put it right here, and I'm right there on that mark again, like that. So that, this actually just works really great. If you got to get on the quarter inch, that might be, you see quarter inch right here, you put it on the base right there. I don't think you can go any further than that. Oh, you probably could. I guess maybe an eighth. Nope, it stopped right there. So there's your quarter of an inch. And a quarter of an inch right here is on that two. Yep, same measurement right there. Cool. So I do like this one a lot, but not for a school. Anyway, so these are good. Now, what to do with this little hole right here is actually, I use the cardboard cutting boards, and we actually do like an emoji pillow, and we cut a circumference, like a circle, and you actually can pin it into your cardboard, and then you have your, let's say we're doing 3 inches, you can actually make it like a compass and kind of go, actually want to keep it. Actually, you could actually do two pins right in there, and then you can do, you know, mark your three, your three, your three, your three, your three, and you can go around like a compass. So that actually works really well. So these measurement gauges are one of the tools we've just been using forever, and also they're really good for spacing out buttonholes. So if you have to go to the end of a buttonhole to the next one, and you know it's 2 inches, and you just space it out. I used to use those a lot when I used to make some shirts and stuff, but now everything's so knit, everything's knits, there's no buttonholes anymore. But those are your measurement gauges. All right, be sure you have one of these in your tool tray. You'll find you're going to use it a lot. So if you have any comments or questions, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll answer them right away. And see you in the next sew bit.